Hello everyone, my name is Arnob and you are welcome to AH Protocol. So what I'm doing today is a commission work, but the lady in this portrait is none other than Frida Kahlo. So I decided to record this work to share with you guys. I believe some of you know who is she, but for those who don't, she was a famous Mexican artist, mostly known for her self-portraits and works inspired by the nature. Well, do you ever heard of the term master of self-portrait? Yes, very well. No. Okay, let me tell you. I'm assuming that you all know the meaning of self-portrait, so I'm not elaborating that. What I'm saying is self-portrait has been a quite interesting subject among the artists throughout the history, and some of the artists had already made history out of it. If you search master of self-portrait on internet, you will get a list of painters and you'll see Frida Kahlo is one of them. She mostly used to work on nature-inspired things, surrealism, magic realism and many more. And let me tell you, she was a self-taught artist of early 19th centuries. Yes, self-taught. Inspiring, right? She has a lot more things in her bucket to inspire you more and more. Just wait, by the end of this video, you will know a lot more interesting and inspiring things about her. You know what? She didn't always want to be an artist. She was fascinated by the science and biology and dreamt of one day becoming a doctor. While helping her father in his photography studio, she got a taste of the arts. Even she took some drawing lessons from a family friend, she never really taught that much of it. When Frida was growing up, polio epidemics were still reasonably common. When she was 6, she caught the virus which caused her right leg to become thinner and shorter than her left. With the help of his father, she bounced back after this illness. I'm just saying that she fought back and she got her strength back, but the process has set an example of tremendous willpower and determination, and from which I believe we all should take lesson to never give up. Unfortunately, the pain and illness never really left her alone. At the age of 18, she had a major accident while traveling in a bus. She was nearly got killed in that crash when an iron handrail went into her hip and came out from other side. On top of this, she also broke her spinal column, collarbone, ribs, pelvis and right leg in 11 pieces, and also dislocated her shoulder too. Although she did eventually recover, she had to have 35 operations over her life to help with her spinal injuries. Frida's long recovery was, however, when she did begin to paint. Due to her injuries, most of the time she used to lay down on her bed with an easel and mostly painting self-portraits by looking at herself in a mirror across the room. During her life, Frida created 143 paintings, including 55 self-portraits. She said, "I paint myself because I am so often alone and because I am the subject I know best." Most of the time, people intended to hide their disabilities, but she painted her injuries and disabilities in a such way so the world was left mesmerized. Her raw and emotional self-portraits often showed her physical and psychological wounds from her life and accidents, with themes of pain, disability and injuries such as the broken column, without hope, two friends, the thorn necklace and the hummingbird, and many more. As the years passed, Frida's health had been getting worse and worse, and she spent the last few years in and out of hospital. In these days, she mainly used wheelchair and crutches to move around. Even so, she continued to paint. In 1953, towards the end of her short life, Frida was excited to opening her first solo exhibition in Mexico. At that time, she was on bed rest under doctor's order. In that physical condition, she arrived at the gallery in an ambulance and she enjoyed her exhibition while lying down on a bed. If this doesn't inspire you, then I don't know what will. She was a pure example of dedication and passion. Yes, sometimes we held back by some conditions. We all have some issues in our lives, but Frida is one of them who showed us that there is no such boundaries to keep you in if you're truly willing to go beyond. Okay. Remember, mates, I am just telling you about this lady in the long skirt in a brief. So her journey and she herself was much more than this. I learned about the Magdalena Carmen Frida Kahlo Y Calderon, aka the Frida Kahlo, from some friends. So thank you Shomik and Shreya for letting me do this work and for telling me the stories about her. And later I researched some more from Wikipedia, from some magazine and from some several websites. And I found an interesting site and I'll put the link on the description if you wanna know more about Frida Kahlo. So here we are and it's the time for final reveal. Have a great day and hope to see you in the next one. Adios amigo.